Hi, I'm Greg Hollows. Welcome to the Imaging Lab. In this video, we're going to spend some time talking about directional illumination. As we've seen in some earlier videos, the direction and structure of illumination can be critically important to what you're trying to see or visualize in a machine vision or imaging application. I have a couple of directional illumination pieces here on the tabletop. I think you can see in the video that we have some light streaming across the table. As you can see in the image that's coming up on the screen, directional illumination can have a variety of effects depending on the surface topography and the actual surface material that is there. Directional illumination can work very, very well when we're trying to look at things like, let's say, a 2D barcode or information that's on the side of a box, something where we're able to get a certain amount of illumination on there and it comes off very clean and we get a high contrast image. Now, the problem with directional illumination, again, if we refer back to the image, is on things that are highly gloss or specular surfaces, we get a lot of high amounts of reflectivity, and it's not necessarily even or something that we can balance out in the system. It generally ends up in one spot being much hotter than another, creating a hot spot. We get a rolling off of the illumination, as in the examples that you see here, very close to the light source, we have a lot of illumination. As we move out, things are getting lower and lower and lower. So for simple applications, for diffuse surfaces, like maybe a tablecloth or something that is a fabric, directional illumination works well, or a flat finished sort of paper or something that's a printing that is not a high gloss finish, directional illumination will work very, very well. Now, as you see here, we have two different types. We have a spotlight and a bar light in this situation. Now, the two different ones can be used depending on the size of the object and what needs to be seen. We're going to see later how something like this that's very long could be used on a curved surface, not something that's flat and get decent illumination, depending on the type of camera we can use. That's going to be in some of the more advanced topics that we covered in structured illumination. But for right now, directional illumination can be very, very effective, again, for flat matte finishes. You can click on any of the suggested videos on the page to take you to another illumination or imaging topic.